Hey, what's up guys? Nonu here. That video that you just saw was filled with Lumion decals. Decals help you create realism and add imperfection and customization in your 3D renders, either by helping to break texture repetition, give you some custom design to your projects, or simply by providing a humanization touch. In today's video, I'll show you 5 ways how you can use Lumion decals and how to apply them in every situation. Stay tuned because this video will be packed with useful tips to create better 3D renders. You will find decals under the Effects category. Just press this button on the top left corner and head over to the last icon called Decals. Here you can find several categories from asphalt, dirt, plaster, road markings and wall damage. To use any decal, you simply left-click it and then place it anywhere you would like on your scene. Decal properties are on the top right corner and by default you can change the color, the range, it's how far you want the decal to be drawn, and the orientation. If you click the Show More button, there are more options. Flip both vertically or horizontally, and then there are material options such as blend colors, blend normals, glossiness, and reflectivity. Let's start with way number 5, road markings. I have here a scene with just a road material. You can even see some slight texture repetition. Our brain is very good at noticing these patterns, so decals are great to hide these repetitions. First, I'll go to Effects, Decals, and then select the road markings. Here I can select a line, I'll add it to my scene and customize some options. For example, I'm making it yellow. I can duplicate a couple of times and then select all of them and add them to a group. This way I don't have to duplicate them one by one. Now I'll select this crosswalk one and add it to my scene. But it's a little small, so I'll just press the L key on the keyboard and scale it a bit. Duplicate a couple of times to make a sidewalk. I'll adjust the transparency and glossiness slider on some of them to create some variation. Have a look at it with variation and without. Makes a big difference, right? Select again the line decal and let's add it to the middle of the road. We can duplicate several instances of this line and create some variation again. Now, as a final touch, let's add some asphalt damage. I'll change the orientation, reduce the scale, and on the color, I'll make it darker to better match my asphalt material. I'll reduce the blend colors to about 75%. And the glossiness to about 25%. Let's add some potholes, and I'll do the same thing as the asphalt damage. Finally, we can add some leaves on the floor, and when I try to place them next to the sidewalk, you can see it's catching not only the road, but also the sidewalk. We can adjust the range, so it doesn't render on top of the sidewalk anymore. And we went from this asphalt material to this one. You can see the big improvement we did by adding the decals. Bonus tip. To better set up your material, go to Photo Mode, then click Build with Effects. Now edit your material, this way all the settings will be that closest to the final render. Now way number 4, material variation. You can add material variation in many different ways with Lumion decals. In this interior scene, we can go to the wall damage category and let's select wall damage 12. Let's add it to this wall, rotate the decal and remove the color. The most important here is to keep the normal map. Now duplicate the decal by pressing Alt and move it to the other side of the wall. Now you see we added some material variation that fits best this industrial design. We can continue to repeat this process to add more material variation to the wall. You can also add some exposed brick using the same technique to enhance even more this industrial design. Adding decals to grass is a great way to create some material variation, to show some areas of grass that are not so pristine anymore, for example. I'll go to the plaster category and I'll select any of these decals. Now I'll place it on the grass, rotate it, scale it, and change the color. I'm trying to find a color that can match well this material and gives a nice variation. Let's adjust the blend color slider to combine better with our grass material. Sometimes some plants don't have any grass below them, so the grass doesn't take the space of the plant. Instead of modeling these areas in the 3D model application, we can simply add a new decal. Let's first add a nice plant or tree. Then we can select this pothole decal, adjust the scale and add it below the plant. I'll make the color darker and remove the glossiness and reflectivity. Let's add a couple of stones to the landscape design. You can find lots of different stones by going to Nature and then Rocks. I can finish this landscape design by adding a couple of small stones around. Check the garden stone collection. Now let's add them around the decal. By the way, if you'd like to take the next step into creating high-quality 3D renders with Lumion, you can join my new Lumion Render course. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And way number 3 is custom designs. You can add your own custom decals. You'll find an icon that has the Lumion logo. You can see it says custom decal. Click it and place it in your scene. Now, let's say we want to add a beautiful art to our scene. We can go to this website and search, for example, minimalist art background. I'm going to select this one. Important note here, I opened this image in Photoshop and you can see its resolution is very high. For better performance in Lumion, let's change the resolution to 2K maximum. And let's save it. To add your custom decal, click on the square box next to the blend color slider. Now, select the image you downloaded and scale it to fit our scene. You can adjust the glossiness slider if you want to have the wall details on your decal. You can also create your own custom design, either by going to Photoshop and simply creating something you would like to see on your project. Or, in my case, I'm going to Midjourney, which is an artificial intelligence tool that allows you to create artistic images from the text description you enter. I like this image, so I'm going to download and use it on my Lumion scene. I will replace the image with the new one I just downloaded. I can adjust some properties and this is the final result. I'm pretty happy with the result. Another use is, let's say this is an office and your client wants you to add the company logo on the wall. You can easily do that. Just load the logo texture without background as PNG, for example, and place the decal where you want the logo to show up. And bonus tip, if you have an image that you want to remove the background, you can now easily do it with different software. Go to this website, upload your image, and in seconds you have your image without the background, ready to use inside Lumion as a custom decal. And way number 2 is custom weathering. With time, buildings tend to have some dirt and weathering on them. With this type of decal, you can simulate weathering on a material. Let's go over to the dirt category and select one of these decals. Usually next to the ground, it accumulates more dirt, so let's place it there. You can add both on the curb and on the sidewalk. Let's add some moss in these areas next to the grass. And we can place some dirt on these areas where water naturally will flow more. You can also place some paint decals with very low color opacity to create some variation. Bonus tip, go to the Advanced and then Weathering tab. Here you can find many preset materials to give weathering to your material. Just don't overuse it. About 10% should be enough for any material if you don't want your design to look like an abandoned place. And number 1, dynamic animations. You can animate these decals to showcase different designs. To do this, let's first add to this wall one custom decal. Now move it to a new layer. Let's call this layer Design 1. Duplicate the decal and move it to a different layer called Design 2. Now we can hide Design 1. Now let's repeat the same process for Design 3. Okay, now that we have done that, let's go to the animation window. First, for a more dynamic shot, let's add some slight camera movement. Now add a new layer management effect and let's keyframe our decals. At 1 second, it shows the first one. Then the second decal, and lastly the third decal. And this is the animation we just created. Bonus tip, create a more interesting camera animation. Set your camera to 24 millimeters. Now move the camera forward and set the camera to 20 millimeters. You now created a vertical shot, which is seen in many movies. As you can see, Lumion Decals gives you the opportunity to create many design and material variations for your projects. Let me know in the comments in what ways are you using Lumion Decals. I'd love to know more ways that you can apply these decals. And before you go, check out this video that will help you get the best PBR materials. And I'll see you in the next one.